What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Say during an interview, you are given the heads of two sorted linked lists. Then you are asked to merge the two lists into one sorted list and return its head. The most intuitive and optimal solution to solve such a problem is making use of the two pointers approach. So each of the pointers, head 1 and head 2, will start at the head of a given list. These pointers will allow us to traverse these lists simultaneously and check at every iteration which current head holds the smaller node value. You see, because both these lists are sorted, then it is guaranteed that the head will always hold the smallest value of the list. Therefore, if the head of the list, let's say, has a smaller value than the second one, then the first head has the smallest value among all the nodes we have, and hence should be added to our final list. This logic is then repeated until our initial nodes are consumed. To implement this solution, and if you recall one of our previous videos, we will start by creating a sentinel node, which will be used to keep track of our generated list's head and return it when we are done. Then, of course, we will need a runner that will be used to traverse and insert nodes into the list we are generating. This node will start at the sentinel. So, while none of the two lists' pointers is null, or while we still have elements inside both lists, we need to check which head holds the smallest value. If the first one does, then this node is appended to our new list, and our runner is moved one node forward. If not, then the second head is appended, and the same modifications are applied. Now, after one of the heads reaches null, meaning that one of the lists does not contain nodes anymore, we need to append the remaining nodes, whether in the first or second list, to the generated list. This is done with the help of the two while loops in front of you. You see, suppose list number 1 is emptied, but 2 still holds elements. At this point, we know that the last element of the first list has a smaller value than all the remaining elements in the second list, meaning that these elements should be appended after that node. With this, you obtain the complete and optimal implementation of the problem at hand. Okay, before scaling up this problem, I would like to suggest a recursive approach to solve it. And as always, to solve a problem recursively, we need to think of the subproblem at hand. So here, suppose that the first head is smaller than the second one. Then the head of the list we are generating will be head number 1. You see, comparing only two nodes here is the subproblem. Okay, but what about the rest of the lists? What about the remaining nodes? Well, if we know that our starting node is the first head, then the nodes following this head will be whatever is the result of merging the two highlighted lists, right? Same applies to the remaining nodes. If the second node is the following element of the generated list, then the node coming after it will be whatever is the result of merging these two lists, and so on. So, to write this recursively, we must keep the same if statements we previously had. However, this time we will attempt to fetch and return one node only, the smallest one. And once we identify which node to return, then its next node in the list will be the recursive call on all the remaining nodes. The breaking conditions of this recursive method will be the ones you see in front of you. So obviously, if the first head is null, then all we can return is the second list's head node, and vice versa. Okay, as soon as you implement one of these solutions, the interviewer might jump in and tell you that instead of having two lists to merge, we now have k sorted lists. So how do we tackle these new requirements? Well, the trivial solution that may directly pop to your mind if you are trying to make use of what we just implemented is loop over these lists one by one and invoke the merge two lists method on each pair. So, as an example, given 4 lists, we will start by merging the first 2, then merge the list we just obtained with the third one, and so on until all of these lists are merged into one sorted list. You see, there is no doubt that this approach will work. However, by making use of this loop, the number of nodes that will have to be retraversed, especially the ones belonging to the first list, will not be optimal. To visualize what I just said, suppose we have the 4 lists in front of you. Now, if we make use of the code we just wrote, these millions of nodes will have to be traversed 3 times. First to merge them with the second list, then the third, and finally the fourth. So, how can we improve on this? Well, we improve this algorithm the same way we improved from bubble sort to merge sort. In bubble sort, each element is treated individually against all other elements, which is exactly what we are doing here. However, when we use the divide and conquer technique, which is what merge sort does, the input is repeatedly divided by 2, until we are sure that our sub-logic is being called on the optimal chunk of data possible. Implementing this solution will seem very familiar to you. So we start by dividing the total lists by 2. The result of merging the first chunk of lists will be one single node, and the result of merging the second chunk of lists is another node. Now, merging these two nodes with the help of the method we previously implemented will result in the node we are looking for. Additionally, inside this recursive call, if the chunk of lists provided contains two lists only, then we also must call our previous method. And if this chunk contains only one list, then that list should be returned as is. With this, you obtain the complete divide and conquer implementation that allows you to merge k sorted lists. You know what I really like about this problem is the ability to tackle it from several angles using multiple approaches. And one additional technique here is traversing all given lists simultaneously with the help of a priority queue. This one I'll leave to you as an exercise, as it kind of has a straightforward implementation. So, the links to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.